Alright guys, so this video is going to focus on how to simplify complex numbers. So first off, we need to realize when we're dealing with complex numbers when it comes to approaching a problem. And complex numbers come in place whenever you're taking the square root of a number that is negative. Now, typically, probably up until this point, you've been told that you just can't take the square root of something negative. It's just not possible. It's a no solution. But of course, us crazy math people decided to go a step further and we're like, well, what if you could? You know, what would happen or what would you get? So when you're simplifying with something that is negative, that is when you're dealing with complex numbers and you start to get into imaginary numbers. I know, right? Imaginary numbers. If real numbers gave us problems enough as it is, now we gotta get into imaginary numbers. So let's focus on how do we simplify these things. So you're dealing with a complex number when you are taking the square root of something that is negative. Now, one thing or one of the important rules that we want to understand is that the square root of -1 is equal to I. So essentially what we do here is we're taking the square root of something that is negative. We want to use the product rule to separate this. Essentially, I'm going to pull out the negative piece from it. I'm going to say that -169 is the same thing as -1 times 169. Remember that the product rule says that I can split this up, right? That way I can take the square root of -1. The square root of -1 is I, and that's just a rule, okay? So you do have to know that rule here because it does pertain to all of these complex problems here. So the square root of -1 is an I, and then you just continue and you simplify the square root of your number just like you normally would simplify a radical. This one happens to be a perfect square, so the square root of 169 is actually 13, so 13 times 13 is 169. The only other thing I would tell you here is instead of writing I13, let's write 13i. That's just considered simpler, it's considered prettier looking. So here our solution would be 13i. We just remove the negative from it and that turns into an I, and then we simplify the other number as we normally know how. All right, so this video is gonna focus on how to simplify complex numbers. So first off, you're dealing with a complex number when you are dealing with taking the square root or some root of a negative number. Right, so when you're dealing with negative numbers underneath that radical symbol, you're dealing with complex numbers. Now the one main thing that we do need to know about complex numbers, other than the fact that normally probably up until this point you've been told that they don't exist, you can't take the square root of something that's negative, that's when you get a no solution. But we are going to deal now with what's going to happen if we do have a negative underneath that radical, because that's now complex numbers, those are our imaginary numbers. So the one main rule that's going to help us out in simplifying these specific problems is this, is that the square root of -1 is equal to I. So this is just a known rule that we need to use. And what it's going to do is it's going to allow us to break down our problem. So instead of taking a look at the square root of -50, what we're going to do is we're going to pull out the negative. So the product rule for radicals says that we can split this number up into a product of two radicals. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say that the square root of -50 is -1 times the square root of 50, right? Because -1 times 50 is -50. And I'm going to split it up this way, that way I can simplify them individually. Square root of -1, well, that is I. Square root of 50, so let's go ahead and break this down. Remember, when it comes to simplifying radicals, you need to simplify it to where it has a perfect square inside of it. So your perfect square is like 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, and so forth. So using only those numbers, you need to be able to break down that given number. So looking at 50, I know that 50 is 25 times 2. So we can go ahead and take the square root of 25. The square root of 25 is 5. I'm going to drop down the I behind it just because it's better to have the number in front and the I behind it, followed by our radical, the square root of 2, which can't be broken up, can't be simplified any further. So that's going to go on the end. So general, just rule of thumb here, the number first, then your I, then your radical tacked onto the end here. So just splitting this up and removing that negative 1 here, which is going to turn into an I, and then break up your number just like you would simplify any other radical that was positive. All right, so this video is going to focus on how to simplify complex numbers. So complex numbers come into place whenever you're taking the root of a negative number. So up until this point, we've been told that we can't take the square root of something that's negative. It's just not possible. We get a no solution for that. Well, now they're going to come into play. And when we're dealing with complex numbers, those are the I's, if you've ever seen those before. And there's two important rules that we're going to have to know in order to simplify down this problem. The first is that the square root of negative 1 is equal to I. The second is that I times I, or I squared, that is equal to negative 1. Okay, so these are two important rules that we definitely need to know in order to do this problem here. So, taking a look at what we have here, we have the square root of negative 33 times the square root of negative 33. So, and I guess there is a third rule, I guess, sorry. When it comes to math, there's just so many different rules. Just depending on the problem, you have, I mean, unfortunately, they pop up all the time. Dealing with any one problem, there's no telling what different rules might pop up in order to solve that problem. And the other rule that would actually pop up in this one here is there is a rule that says a radical times itself is equal to its radicand. So like square root of negative 33 times square root of negative 33 is negative 33. And this would actually be our final answer here. Now there is a second way that you can look at this problem here instead of going straight to that. This is the quickest, shortest, easiest way to get to the solution in this problem here. Though every once in a while, everybody thinks a little bit differently, so that might not have been the first thing that popped into your head. So I'm going to solve this a different way here. So I'm just going to rewrite the problem all over again. So using our I rules over here, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to break up negative 33 to the square root of negative 1 times 33. And the same thing for this one, square root of negative 1 times 33. Now the square root of 1s, so the square root of 1 is I, so I get an I there for those. Square root of 33 actually cannot be broken up. There's no perfect square that fits inside of it. There would be no way to break those up. Now, we do need to continue to simplify these, and the way that we can simplify these is by multiplying, combining them together. I times I is I squared. Square root of 33 times square root of 33, that's using this rule that I mentioned up here. A radical times itself is that radicand. So we get 33 there. But remember that I squared, so I times I, or I squared, is equal to a negative 1. So I squared is a negative 1, and that 33 drops down with it. Now, in my opinion, it was much easier to use this route here. But then again, some people think a little bit differently, and using the rules of I over here, you can simplify it in a different way.